Yeah, we'll spot you in here. You're looking, yeah, the only thing you'll need to do is tilt once you get in. You're looking good.
Need to go higher or high
enough for it? There you go. That's good. Tie you up. Actually, you'll probably have to go up because if he tilts down, he's going to slam. There you go. Now tilt. Beautiful, Tyler. How's he on your side, Morgan? Okay, that's looking really good. A little more, Ty. A little more. Just keep creeping like that.
Where are you looking, boys?
So he's looking good. I would tilt that down now, nice and slow. Oh, yeah. Yeah, just there you go, like that, Tyler.
How close are you to the glass there?
You got about a foot, brother. You're looking really good, actually.
You want it more forward?
This is lovely, Ty. There you go.
Right there?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll put
her down. Oh, yeah, it's freaking gorgeous is what it is.
Friends, what we're doing is we're getting out of the cold and we're going to bring this sucker inside Tyler's shop. He's got heat going in there and we're going to strap her down, get it all centered. Morgan's got some good ideas with moving. Friends, we were going to bring a trailer and we just thought, no, we made all the measurements. He measured his box. I measured the cab and told him what we need outside to outside. And he built a little ramp in there and friends, it worked like a dream. And he put little screws of wood on the outside. Once we laid the cab on there, it was beautiful. Anyway, just wanted to share that part.
Getting out of the wind.
Hey, Morgan. I know you're watching this video. I see you. Buddy, man to man, friend to friend. Thank you, buddy. Sincerely. No crazy, I don't know any other dude that would help me with this. I don't. You just thank you from this community and from my heart and from my family. Thank you. Wild West Garage, friends, go over to his channel. Give him a big thanks from this community.
These island boys.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to strap her down.
So years go by and you're feeding a family and you're getting banged up and you're getting, you know, you're paying the bills and you're driving around a vehicle that, you know, people kind of, you know, laugh at you a little and think, oh man, this guy's not doing very good in life. Look at this beat up old truck. And you're just ticking along and you got a bird's nest at home, you know, with the birds and then, you know, bring home the bread, you know, feed the family. And you need certain tools. A man needs certain tools to do that if he didn't stay in school, right? And a truck is one of those for a woodman anyways, a guy who chose to live with his body, make a living with his body. And friends, we just found a cab in Regina and we're here and we're loaded. And I'll get into it a little more when we get out of this guy's hair. We done good, friends. Tyler, thanks. If you're ever watching this, you probably aren't, but because you're a busy guy. Huge, way ahead of where we would be starting online. Crookie lives. It's a beautiful day.
Look at this thing, friends. So, is that a real squirrel sitting there on the ground? Is that a sleeping squirrel, friends? Oh, it's a rabbit. It's a rabbit. So here's the deal with these. I had one of these. It was a 1972. Excuse me. It was a 72 Triple E automotive. Oh, the doors are wiped out of the split. There's something about these trucks. Like, oh my good gosh. Are you freaking serious right now? I'm okay, that's I gotta go talk to that guy right now. What a beautiful truck. British Columbia. Look at that, friends. April 88, British Columbia. Triple E automotive. Splitter, no doubt it's got a splitter. Yeah, splitter, same thing. These are beautiful trucks. Tachometer back. Yep, this brings back memories. This was Big Green, friends. Good old Big Green. Look at this old white truck back here. I'm probably not allowed back here, but oh my gosh, they're everywhere back here. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that beautiful, friends? Look at that one. Merc. It's a Merc. It's a water truck. Look at this truck. Doesn't look like it's been running a while. The grill's mint. 73. It's a 350. It's probably a dump truck. Keys are in it. What a glorious truck. I think it's just a flat deck. No, it is a dump. It's a dump. Look at that Merc. Gosh. They're just everywhere. This truck hasn't moved in a long time. Alberta. Look at that. Oh, that's been sitting for a long time, friends. Oh. It's beautiful. I gotta talk to him. That is... Oh my God. Well, here we are in Banff. Just leaving. It's beautiful here. Is this Wolf Street? Yeah, we turn right here. It's a little Christmas town. Banff's kind of cool. Not much going on. Pretty early.
So we're kind of wondering what this is up here, friends. It's kind of like some kind of freaking avalanche control or some freaking thing. It looks weird, but it's definitely man-made. That's what that is. Yeah, that would be... Yeah, Rogers Pass, shankety clang. We got snow, friends. You're doing all right, aren't you?
Friends, so sometimes when I make these videos, friends, I seriously get nostalgic, and I look back and I don't like telling people anything really, I because we're all gonna do what we're gonna do, right? I'm just a dude who made his living with trucks and saws. That's it. When I build these videos for you, and right now at this point of the video where I'm looking at these old trucks, friends, I flash back to when I had no children and I was a lost man, young, just sobered up, you know, almost took myself out and then got my bearings and was like, you know, what am I going to do with these things? What am I going to do? And I've said it on my channel 1,000 times and I'll say it again 1,000 times to anybody who will listen, to follow your freaking spirit, to follow your dreams. For as corny as that sounds, what are you going to do? You're going to say you should have done that when you're 70 and 80, when it's all over and you can't move? You're going to say you should have? Well, it's going to be too late. I took a chance on myself. When I was 27 years old and I started buying old trucks and power saws. And here I am now. That's why I get goofy about this sometimes, because there's no other shoe going to drop, or if you're expecting to see something different, like, this is what I did. This is what happened to me. This is my story. So this story can be yours too. You just have to, if you want to, listen to this thing in here. If it says, hi, I wish I could do this, or I wish I could do that, you can. You can. Do you know how I got my first truck, friends? We had nothing. Nothing. We were trying to scrape together $1,500 a month to pay a mortgage and to eat and to pay the utility bills around here. I had quit my job as a salesman and I bought a couple power saws. And I had no truck. I had no means of getting anything around or nothing. And I went to my stepdad, Ken. You know Ken. And I said, Ken, this is uncomfortable, but I'm getting firewood orders and I need a truck. I found a truck, but I don't have $500. My first truck was the original Myrtle, friends. She was in 1975. I don't have pictures because it was way before freaking YouTube. Friends, sorry, I sidetracked. I totally wanted to say this. I went to Ken because my dad wasn't, you know the story. So I just said, Ken, please, I'll get you 6 cords of premium fir. Like, he burnt firewood. So I was like, I think I told the story a little while ago, but if I don't tell now, you're going to be wondering. He lent me $500, friends. I went and bought my truck. It was a 1-ton 75 Ford crew cab. And her name was Myrtle, before Myrtle. That's a fact. And I got him his firewood within a week, and that truck was paid for, and I was rolling a 306. Listen to the Woodman song. Listen to the Woodman song. And a straight six was her claim, was her fame.
A body that's holding you back, that's frustrating.
I got 15 years of cutting, even more, before the camera turned on, friends. You know? So, more than that. I cleaned gutters. I worked on farms. Just because you want to be a tree man or a logger or whatever you want to be. Friends, I sold firewood and cleaned gutters and did whatever and hauled things away with my truck. A man and his pickup truck have a bond. They have a bond. And the bond is, the man keeps the truck rolling and the truck keeps the man rolling. So I would be nothing without pickup trucks, 1-tons, 3-tons, you know, just trucks. I resurrected so many freaking trucks in my day. I'm now coming up on 55 years old, looking back on a freaking career of pickups and trucks and wood and logging. I'm not done, but I rarely, you know, I haven't production cut in a long time. I cut for whoever I want, whenever I want. But whenever I build a video like this, friends, and I look back I start looking back, I start going, you know, it's not, it takes a lot of work. Yes, it does. It takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of work. There's no way around it. Did I plan on being on YouTube and having people walk up my driveway and try to shake my hand and tell me stories? No, I wasn't expecting that. And I actually don't like it. Get a pickup truck. Get a lawnmower. Get a saw. Get some pruners. Get some hand tools. Get a shovel. Get a rake. Go do things people can't do themselves. There will come a time in my life where I probably won't be able to do certain things physically. And I'll have to call on some young, strong man. Or woman. You know, it's my message is simple here. My message is simple here. I'm not here to yard on my suspenders and be some tough guy or some influencer. I'm here to tell you that if you work hard, be honest, and be kind to people, your life's going to change. It's gonna. And if you do the opposite of that, your life's also going to change. But you got a much better chance of making friends and being nice to people and serving your humankind, serving your fellow man, so to speak, or woman and child. That's the answer to all of this, to all of this. But people get afraid. They get afraid. They think if they give, they won't have. But it's actually the opposite of that. That's my experience. So, that's my story today. The truck is at Morgan's now. We got it home. And we're going to start looking now for parts because I owe it to that truck. I owe it to that truck and I owe it to me and to my little legacy here to fix up that truck and pack my family around it. And if I one day take myself, my wife, and my two kids and go get a Christmas tree with that truck all solid on the frame again and stout in its stance, standing proud, I almost get a wobbly chin thinking about it. So it don't matter what means to you, what means the most to you in your life. That's what you hold on to. That's what you hold on to. And don't justify what you're doing to nobody. Don't be concerned what other people think of you, what you're doing, because it's just going to slow you down. I don't care what you think of me. Be great if you liked me, but if you don't, it means nothing to me. And it should be the same to you. So stop worrying about other folks and focus on what you're doing. And now I'm starting to sound like I'm telling you what to do. Well, I kind of am. You get what you give. This video is done. That was a long trip. It was a long trip. I'm no good sitting. It was physically, it was demanding, to be quite honest with you, for me. Anyway, it's not raining, so I'm going to go out and move around today and get Brian some wood. He called right before I left and he needed another load of wood. So I'm going to go up to Vartan's in the crew cab, in the freaking crew cab.
You got a flat tire.
I know I got a flat tire. My wife saw my flat tire. It's because I left it for 5 days. So I'll pump it up and I'll go.
Straight to Cedar and just get it fixed.
Yeah, it's probably got a screw in it. I've been pumping that tire up for about 3 years now. It's got a slow leak. My wife just chuckles. Isn't that what we're like though, fellas? Isn't it? We are, aren't we? Anyway. Our stories are so important, friends, to us. I'm talking to everybody right now, but mainly men. Start now. Fellas, start now. Don't wait. I was 27 when I changed everything. 27. I felt like I was behind. I felt like I was behind. I really, really enjoy that you come here. I don't care why you come here. You may come here for one reason or two or three different reasons. But friends, I'm an evolving man. And I'm telling you, you're going to see real when you come here. You're going to see real. I've dedicated myself to this YouTube channel, uploading at least every day or every second day or whatever. It's what I'm doing. So you're going to see what I'm doing. If I'm cutting, I'm cutting. If I'm not cutting, I'm not cutting. I'm going to see you on the next one. I'm going to roll and go shoot some more freaking content. Over and out. I got some good news to share with you, too, from a company that sent us something. And it blew my mind, actually. And I felt very honored about it. BuckandBaileyRay.com for your lovely toque that you see bouncing around on my head. It's Christmas. Christine says she can go to the 14th. If you're looking for any of the goodies from the website and at BuckandBaileyRay.com, she says the last day, if you want to get your hubby or something or your family something from the store, 14th of December. She's murdering it. She's just like pounding stuff. She's like eBay. 3 days later, people are getting their stuff. But that will end on the 14th. But I just wanted to say thank you. Oh boy, oh boy. Well, friends, what a journey. This is us rolling on to the ferry at Duke Point. We just beelined it and we made it to the 5:45 ferry. And we're just rolling on here and it's a 2-hour boat ride and we roll right into Cedar. What a journey. Thank you all so much for watching. We'll catch you on the next video. Work hard, be honest, friends, and be kind to one another. I love you.